ask. Well, I have my mother and her fella come to stay with us on Friday until Sunday. On Friday, we are throwing a charade, so to speak, a Christmas party, in other words, for the mother, her fella. My daughter's dad and his missus, and my daughter's stepbrother, my missus' mum and dad, so the mother and father-in-law. I guess I'll go invite the missus, and there'll be me, obviously, because there won't be a party without me. My daughter will be here, a couple of her mates, and it's only a small house, so it's going to be a bloody nightmare. Saturday, if we're still walking after Friday, we're going to have a family meal and more drinks. Sunday, I'll be knackered. Monday is 2 days before Christmas, and we've still got presents to buy, presents to wrap. We've still got flipping decorating to do before Friday. Yeah, I've had the bloody kitchen replastered. I've got to paint all that yet. I did paint the tiles, lovely dark grey. And then my father-in-law knackered him up when he plastered. I ain't kidding you. He said, I'll go around and do the plastering. I said, fair enough. I can't do it, so you can do it. That's good. There was plaster everywhere. It was like I'd walked into a plaster warehouse. I was like, what the hell? So I'm still cleaning that up. He's just absolute flipping stress. But when I brighten up, it is Christmas, and I've got to talk to you about what happened when I met with Santa about a week or two ago on his mini break in Wolverhampton before the Christmas spirit really kicked in. He said to me, I'm going to tell you exactly what he said, over the course of the next few videos or so. I don't know how many we're going to get through, but altogether, there's 12 conversations I had with this bloke, yeah? And I'm going to tell you about each one of them, and some of them you might not believe, some of them you might believe. I'm going to sip my coffee whilst we talk about it. On top of all this bloody bar humbug stuff, I got up late. I hate getting up late. I slept in. It was 10 to 8. I can't believe it. I wanted to get, like, my videos done at 10, from 6 to 8. So, now we're playing rush. Okay. When I met with Santa a couple of weeks ago in Wolverhampton for a coffee and a cookie, he said to me, Ollie, this is what he said. On the first day of Christmas, Santa said to me, I'll tell you what he said, bear with us. I've got to find it again because I wrote all this down as he told me. He said, Ollie, why the hell is it that Liverpool have run away with the title and is Pep now done at City? I said, Santa, you've got way too much time on your hands if you're watching Liverpool and Man City. Get down Old Trafford and watch Man United. Or better yet, go down Scunthorpe. He said, no, Ollie, I love my Liverpool and I love my Man City. Okay, I'm going to watch them when I can, alright? I said, alright, Santa, whatever, mate. Let me tell you all about it. I said, Liverpool are top of the table because everybody else is so poor. I said, Liverpool have one team to thank for the fact that they have now won the league before Christmas. One person, and it's not you, Santa. Oh, no. It isn't you, you ho. No, it is Man United. Man United beat Man City recently at the Etihad Stadium, which pretty much guaranteed Liverpool the title. Man United were feeling sorry for Liverpool. They thought, bloody hell, Leicester have won a title in the last few years. In the past, Blackburn have won a title. God help us, Arsenal have won more than one title in the Premier League. Even Chelsea have got themselves a couple. Us, obviously, Man United, we've had the majority, of course. But it's only right that we share a little holiday spirit and give Liverpool at least one title. You know, Stevie G couldn't do it. He was a bit of a flop in the end, weren't he? You know, Liverpool's best player. so Santa said to me. But Ollie, Liverpool have been fantastic now for like 2 years. They've come so close in the last 2 years. I said, Santa, of course they've come close, like that close, but not to the finish line, because Liverpool never make it to the finish. So we helped them out. And then Tottenham felt a bit sorry for them. So Tottenham started really badly on purpose. And they thought, okay, we lost Champions League last season. We need to get Jose Mourinho in now. We'll start deliberately bad under Poch. This is what the players thought, to give Liverpool a better chance of winning the league. That way, they might stop moaning about it all the time. I said, Santa, on the subject of Man City. Now that is a different prospect altogether. Man City have what I like to call too many presents under the tree. Okay? They got a bit greedy. They were writing their Christmas list to you, Santa. And Pep was there like, okay, Santa, all I want for Christmas is a Premier League title, a Champions League, a League Cup, an FA Cup, a Charity Shield. I want Messi. I want Busquets. Gerard Piqué. I want all the best players in the world that have ever played for me. And then every other best player in the world as well. I want Raheem Sterling to be the best Premier League player. The best English Premier League player. I don't want to have to use Phil Foden more than 2 times in a season. Make sure it happens, Santa. I don't need a new defender. Why would I need a new defender? I have the best defender in the world, John Stones. We have to win the league by 400 points this year, Santa. We cannot concede a goal. We have to score 50 goals in every game. And I want to make sure we beat Liverpool in the Champions League final. Okay? And I want Liverpool relegated from the Premier League. That is what he wanted under his tree, Santa. And that is why Man City are now falling away. Also, his ego got a little bit big for the door. Yeah, he couldn't get through the door at the Etihad because his ego got that big. He thought, I'm bigger than all this. We don't need to try anymore. We don't need a new defender. We don't need a new defender. We already have John Stones. And if I need a new defender, I'll just stick Fernandinho in there. Yeah, he tried to sing Tina Turner at the karaoke Christmas party, Santa. But rather than singing about, we don't need another hero, instead he sang, we don't need another defender. That's how cocky he was getting. He was in Liverpool, just down the road from Anfield, singing, we don't need another defender. And he started slugging off Virgil van Dijk. So, you gotta ask yourself, what kind of idiot would do that? And that is Pepe Le Pew. I can't help it. It's just, that's just the way he is. Now, I hope that answers your question, Santa. Now, Santa sat there. He had a quizzical look on his face. Yes, Ollie. I now grant you 12 wishes. Well, one wish of 12. If you answer the rest of my questions, then you can get the 12. I said, okay, Santa. My first wish is, let me think this one through. For to live happily ever after and be mega rich. Hell yeah, please. He said, I can't do that, Ollie. I said, why is a wish? He said, I don't give out monetary gifts at Christmas, okay? You'll have to make do with a Asda voucher. Right, guys, that is day one of my conversation with Santa. Done in the bag. Ho, ho, ho. Christmas.